All right, so one point I definitely want to cover is this concept of the screw home mechanism in the knee. So what I want you to do is I want you to take a look at the lateral and medial femoral condyles. Obviously, this is gonna be my medial femoral condyle over here. We know that's my medial femoral condyle, but because look, hey look, there's a femoral head. So this has to be the medial side. So what I want you to see is I want you to see how oblong and how long that medial femoral condyle is compared to the lateral condyle. This is really going to make a big difference when we start talking about this concept of a screw home mechanism, okay? Second point is looking at my tibia and fibula complex. Again, notice the difference between my lateral tibial condyle. I know this is my lateral side because my fibula is over here. Compare that to the medial femoral condyle. I'm sorry, medial tibial condyle. So medial tibial condyle, a lot more surface space, a lot more space for a sliding to happen. So as I am locking the knee, and what I mean when I say locking the knee, as you can see up on the screen, what I'm looking at here is I'm looking at moving from a flexed position to an extended position, okay? So basically I'm moving from a mini squat up to standing. That is going to lock the knee. If I'm going to unlock the knee, I'm talking about moving from a standing position down to a squat. Obviously with both of those, we're looking at the closed chain. So to lock the knee, I'm going from about 30 degrees of knee flexion up to full extension. I understand the screen says 20 degrees. It happens between 20 and 30 degrees. So in other words, I'm moving from the loose packed or open packed position of the knee up to the closed packed position. Again, to unlock the knee, what's gonna happen is I'm gonna move from full extension into about 20 to 30 degrees of flexion. Now when this happens, because we have this abnormally shaped condyle, is when I lock my knee, so again, going from a flexed position up to an extended position, the lateral femoral condyle, this guy here, stops. It doesn't move anymore. The medial femoral condyle continues as arthrokinematics. So what happens is as I continue to extend, I have a little bit of rotation that happens because this condyle has stopped moving and this one has not. That's gonna happen in the closed chain. Reason being is because when I'm working in the closed chain, my tibia is essentially gonna be fixed against the ground. Now when I go in the open chain, same type of concept. I'm gonna have my lateral tibial condyle stop moving as opposed to my medial tibial condyle. I wanna show you a quick video to kind of bring this point home. So this is exactly what's going to happen. Take a look at those mechanics. Obviously, the other point to note here is look at the patella and look how that tibia moves open chain. So we don't just have sagittal plane motion here, we also have transverse plane motion. I definitely want to make sure that everyone understands that. Like I said before, the easiest way to do this is to palpate your femoral condyles in the closed chain and palpate your tibial condyles in the open chain. So definitely make sure that you're looking at both of those and you understand how those mechanics work.